Hello guys, today we are going to compare two popular video editing tools. On one side we have Adobe Premiere Pro and on the other side we have Sony Vegas Pro. We are going to compare their rendering qualities and see which one might be better than the other. So guys, we are going to start with the Adobe Premiere Pro version 13, which is the 2019 CC, and we are going to use the graphics accelerated option, which allows us to use even our graphics card. I have my AMD graphics card, so we are going to use that option. Otherwise, if you don't have a graphics card, you'll only have this engine software only, but that one I assure you it's very slow. So we are going to use this optimal one, and we are going to select the name of the file, the name of the project, and then down here you say okay. So we are going to import a file from our PC. And then load it onto the timeline. So we are going to render this particular video. So we go to file. Down here you have export. You go to media. And basically we are going to export it into an MP4 format, which is using the encoding format or the compression format of H.264. Notice that we have H.265, which is a newer method, probably invented in the early 2013s. But I usually advise my users and viewers to make sure that they select the H.264 because of compatibility issues, because some of the devices don't support H.265. This is the one that I'm talking about. Please don't use this one unless you're very sure that wherever you're going to use it, it's going to be compatible. Then change the file name. Yes, then okay. Then down here, we have to change something. The video settings, we are going to change. You're going to make sure it's 1080. You're going to look at the frame rate, make sure it's standing at 29.97. Otherwise you can change this one, you can deselect and change, but we are going to use that one. Down here, target, we are going to make sure that the target bitrate is at 10 and the maximum bitrate is at 12. So when we do that, we are going to make sure we select only the one pass, because the two pass has to go like double. So we are going to make sure we use the one pass. But when you are trying to render something to a better quality, try to use the two pass. It will give you much cleaner video. So we are going to change the audio. Look at the audio and make sure it's at ASC. Down here, sample rate, 48,000 hertz. Serial channel, high quality at 320. This is what we are going to use. I think here we won't change a lot. So we're going to export that and see what we have in terms of the quality, and also in terms of the time taken to do that particular task. We're also going to load the same video on Sony Vegas version 18. I told you this is the 2020 version. So we are going to also load it here. We are going to import the file, the same file, and then load it onto the timeline, then render it. We are going to go to file, render as. Notice that in Adobe Premiere Pro, it's called export. Right here is rendering. If you use the export, you're going to have other options, but not the rendering option. So kindly use the rendering option. Here we want the AVC stroke AAC MP4. That is the H.264 video compression. This is the option that offers that. And here we can select the internet. We can select one preset so as to edit. We can select this one. I want you to notice that we have 29.97 frames per second, but this one has the Intel QSV versus this one which doesn't have. So if you use this one, it is the graphics accelerated option. If you use this one, it's the software only option. So use this one for a better result. But we are going to customize it to fit exactly what you want. So we go to customize the template. You can see this is the size of the video. It's 1080 HD. And the frame rate is the same as in Adobe. And also, if you go down here, the field order. Okay, leave that. The aspect ratio is 1, which is square. And we go to the bitrate. We can use the constant or the variable one. We are not going to use 2Pass again in this case because we want to just use the same settings as in Adobe Premiere Pro. So we are going to use an average bitrate. We set it to 10 Mbps in Adobe Premiere Pro. And right here we are going to set the maximum bitrate to 12 Mbps. Now that is done, we go down here, encode mode, make sure is at this one, Intel QSV, so as to use your graphics card. Now, from there, we don't have anything else to do. Remember, we had the sample rate here at 48,000, but this bitrate was at 320 kilobit per second, so we make sure it's 320. And then the rest, you don't have to change anything. Now these are the average settings. Once you press OK, you're going to start rendering. So I'll press this button in 3, 2, 1. Well, now I have put the files together in one folder and we are going to actually try to look at the differences if there is any. We start with the file size. We can see this, the one from Adobe stands at 317 MB and the one from Sony, it's actually the same. So actually in terms of size, if you use the same settings, you should not expect much change. Now, we can look at the quality. That is for the Adobe. This is the Sony. There is actually no visible difference between the two. Well, the two softwares have done well in terms of quality and in terms of size. Apart from the rendering speed, where Sony Vegas smashed Adobe Premiere Pro by almost half the time. Thank you guys for watching. If this video is interesting to you, kindly give us a like. And if you have anything to say, we have the comment section. I'm going to try to answer anything that you have. And if you really like more videos from our channel, please subscribe to FourniLearn. We have links in the end of this video. Kindly subscribe. Thank you and see you in the next one.